capital work in progress, whenever you construct a building and is not constructed as building which is ready to use, till then it is capital work in progress. Capital work in progress. Any asset created but not created to the stage you can ready put to use, it is a capital work in progress. The term only. Cash book, you know cash book. Cash flow statement, from the cash book, cash received, cash paid, a flow statement, opening balance, received, payment, cash flow. How cash comes, how cash goes. That is treated as cash flow statement. Chart of account, account chart, all account I have discussed, chart of account. Contingent liability, your answer, contingent liability. This will be a contingent liability, okay? Contingent liability is the liability which has not become a liability to pay at the end of the year. But it may come on the company, may not come on the company depending on the situation which may arise in future. That become the contingent liability. Contra entry, one entry cover the other entry, okay? One check, like stale check, okay? You are not paid the stale check entry. But one check cancelled, one check issued. So you have to again make a check and cancel and check both the side. It will become the contra entry. Cost of acquisition, cost. Cost means anything you bring, you purchase, you whatever acquire, and to that extent to which it is ready to use, it has to be used, or it has to put for consumption, whatever it is. To that, whatever amount you incur, it becomes the cost in any manner. Cost of acquisition, same acquire in case of acquisition. Credit, I already discussed credit. Okay. Current asset, I discussed you current asset. Current asset means the assets which are reliable next 12 months, either in cash or in debtors or in sale, or the stock in trade is current asset because it is sellable. Raw material is current asset because it will be current asset, finished goods, then will convert it like that. So current asset, current asset, current liability is payable within the next 1 year or the operating cycle. There can be a company or industry where the operating cycle means purchase, sale, realization, maybe 3 year, 2 year, 4 year, a shipping industry, okay? You want to construct a ship, so it will, the construction will take 4 year, 5 year, so that will be current liability, don't note 1 year. Normally, the period is 1 year. Debit, I discussed. Deferred revenue expenditure, as you discussed that time now, whatever expenditure you incurred this year, but will be used for next 4 year, 3 year, 5 year, you put deferred revenue expenditure. Then out of which, suppose you are utilizing an expenditure of 4 year, 1/4, every year you debit to the expenditure. Deferred revenue expenditure. It will coming under the asset side because revenue expenditure incurred, but deferred because this expenditure could not be used for the revenue of this year. It will be usable for another years also. Then deficit, ghata, loss, deficit. Depreciable amount, the amount on which you provide the depreciation. I have put this furniture, it cost is 10,000. Okay, so on 10,000 I can called depreciation. Repair, maintenance, upkeeping is not cost. So that is not depreciable amount. On amount on which I claim depreciation is a depreciation. Depreciable method, there are two, three methods. When it returned on method with straight line, 10,000 purchased, 10 years is life, 110. Okay? 10,000 purchased, life I don't know, 10 years it may be, but first year it will be used very, look very nice. Okay, it will give more value. Second year, it will be, you know, old, will give less value. So first year, 15%, another return down value 15%, then return down value basis. So it depends on the type of asset and the method you follow. Dividend income, when your share is invested by me in a company and company pays me something, it is a dividend income, out of income. Double entry bookkeeping, discussed. Earmark fund. Certain funds you are also receive earmark, like some grant fund, earmark for a particular grant, earmark for a particular course, earmark for a particular subject, particular seminar, that is earmark fund. You cannot use those fund for other purposes. Normally for such fund, if it is regular 12-year account is running, then in 12-year account, in 12 month there is a running account, then separate bank account is kept or a separate cash book is kept for such earmark fund, certain grant fund you are utilizing, certain building fund, you will have separate cash book or a separate account if no major entries are there. Fair market expenses, discuss expenses, fair market value, if something is purchased or sold or valued at a particular price, then you say we are accounting all the transactions on historical cost, on the cost basis. But sometimes somebody wants that what is the fair market value of the transaction. He may examine your cost or a new system is introduced. Abhi aapke, it has not come in education system to have a fair market value because it has come only in the big corporates, okay, having the turnover listed companies, etc., etc., that they have to give fair market value of their assets, okay, but it's not come to education institution. And if some education listed company or a big corporate and having a you know turnover more than 500 crore, then it will be applicable to them. So fair market will there. Financial statement, I told balance sheet, income statement, statement of another supporting statement, other presented financial data are to be recorded on financial statement. P&L balance is main two statement. Notes on account you appended, okay? And other enclosure, suppose the income add is one, you want to give more sub-adds. They are annexed schedules, etc. They are the financial statement. Fixed asset, I discussed with you. Fixed deposit, deposit for a specified period is fixed deposit. Funds, I discussed the fund. Generally accepted accounting principles, I'm telling you the accounting will not applicable. They are generally accepted accounting principles. When no principle is applicable, no standard is applied to particular, then generally accepted accounting principles are made applicable to that. Grants, we are having the grants, amount given by other body to use for specific purposes or for general purposes. If grant is specific, then you have a specific grant account. If not general grant, then we credit to the income account. Income is income. Income tax expense account discussed with you. Interest we discuss on any loan received or paid. Okay, any deposit received or paid, we have to pay some interest, that is interest. Internal control. Internal control means if your transaction is checked by other person or all transactions audited by somebody internally. For internal control means the transactions which are entering the books of account are properly recorded. For that, there is internal control system. One person does not make payment, one person only does not make all entries. So they have a control, one internal check, one person check, another person. Or there is the internal auditor coming outside, or there is system software, or there is a management check, there is any check. All the check, or there are formats of reporting, standard form of reporting, all these taken together is constituted as internal control. Means there has to be a system where intensely somebody wants to commit a mistake, the system will reveal the mistake. So that is the internal control system. Investment, if something is held, invested for investment purpose, investment. Suppose you have extra funds, you invested in some. Investment means the activity which the company is not carrying, which the entity is not carrying, and surplus funds are invested. That is called the investment. Okay? Whenever we make fixed deposit, routine period is not investment. It is putting extra funds for a time being. But I am making securities investment. Then I am investing the money because I have surplus fund. I want to go in the secondary market. Or I want to invest in other companies' capital. So that is the investment. Inter-unit transaction, if inter-department, inter-unit transaction, suppose you want to transfer some furniture to the department or some amount to pay it by them or some cash transfer you are making, inter-department transfer. Sometimes you don't have fund. You are receiving fund from other inter-department. You have to credit the department. That department will debit to you. So when all department reconcile, then all debit credit will be nil. So inter-department entry at the year end becomes nil. Infrastructure assets. Those assets with character of being a part of specialized nature, use, removal, and subject to condition. Infrastructure asset. Infrastructure means, suppose this institute, we are building IIT. So we have to provide infrastructure. What infrastructure? Land leveling, roads, building, etc. No, building is used for education, not infrastructure. Roads, lighting, etc. All infrastructure. So that a common person, when he come to the IIT center, then he go to the basic facilities. So basic facilities, which reaches to the institution, or which are supposed to be provided to the person operating here under, are called the infrastructure facility. Okay? It is separate for up. For municipality, infrastructure is to make road, to make bridges, to make drainage, to make sewerage, all infrastructure for them. So, this is infrastructure. Journal book, entry cash book, we go by cash entry. Other than cash payment, we were making transaction, one debit, one credit, that is called journal. Okay? Separate journal is made for that. One debit and one credit, so we make a journal entry or we make a journal book. Journal entry, we discuss lapse deposit, ledger deposit. This is the pro forma of the ledger. You have seen date, particular, cash book folio, debit and credit. First debit, then credit. And last may the balance, debit or credit net balance. Lease, somebody is taken on rent or lease is a lease. Okay? We give some property on lease. It is a type of renting arrangement. Liability, we discuss liability. What is liability? Long-term investment. There are two types of investment, one short-term, one long-term. Long-term investment, normally investment which are realizable more after 1 year. Long-term investment. Investment made in, realizable within 1 year is short-term investment. That is the theory which we are normally used for short-term and long-term in the accounts. Mortgage, suppose any land, property, building is charged to somebody against the loan or anything guarantee, then we need the term mortgage, okay? Educational fund, you all know. Narration, suppose we make an entry and we give the narration, this matter was purchased on this rate at this, etc. from this party or whatever amount narration we make, or this terms, etc. That is narration. And if before any entry, we put some detail of entry, that become the narration. Net assets, are you a net asset? There are different type, different word you use, net asset. What is your asset, what is your liability? The increase of the asset or liability is net asset. Sometimes net asset is used in the terms of current asset, sometimes it is fixed asset, sometimes it is total asset. So net asset means whenever a requirement to show is what asset, okay? Net means asset minus liability, net asset is net asset. Current asset we show, current asset or current liability, net current asset. Okay? That is type would net asset. When something liability is netted to asset, it becomes a net asset. Net block, suppose you purchase funding for 10,000. Okay, 1,000 depreciation charge. So 10,000 minus 1,000. 1,000 go to profit and loss account debit side. Out of 10,000, 1,000 is incurred. So it will be expenditure. Because expenditure asset is one side. So 10,000 furniture purchase, 1,000 consumed. We use the 10-year life, 1,000 is consumed in this year. 1,000 go to depreciation. So 10,000 minus 1,000, 9,000 is the net block. Okay? Net block. So net block will furniture, fixture, asset, all total. Total assets minus total depreciation will give you net block. Block means, block normally is referred for the fixed asset. For the other than current asset, block, net block, net asset. Period end, the last day of any accounting period is quarterly, half yearly of period end. Prepaid expenses, the expenditure paid this year, but will be, benefit will be next year. Suppose you have given the, you know, you have taken a policy or a driving insurance of vehicle on 1st January up to 31st December, 9 months is prepaid. So that is why your fees and other expenses will also cover in the prepaid and unearned or unpaid. That we also cover. But where the system is regular, you can go by the accounting treatment and accounting policy also. Ratio analysis means we put current ratio, turnover ratio, debt ratio. Suppose you have 1 crore capital and turnover is 10, so turnover to capital ratio, 1:10. Suppose you have said 1 crore asset and 50,000 capital, so asset to capital ratio, 1:2. So the relevant ratios which are relevant to each other are ratio, like debt equity, how much total debt, how much equity. In a business you have put 1,000 rupees, so 250 is your debt, 750 equity, so debt is 1:3. So people will say you have invested 1 and take a borrowing 3. So people examine the ratio. So ratio analysis makes you in the long way, because you will compare the ratio year to year. What was the ratio in previous year? What was the 2 year back? Now what is the ratio? So you can compare year to year, and therefore you can take a decision. For that decision making, ratio analysis is done. It is varied analysis done in lot of, in the material ratio, consumption ratio, capital out ratio, total outside ratio, net worth, and you know, debt equity to hai, other than debt equity, lot of ratios, profitability ratio, turn expenditure to expenditure ratio, earning to earning ratio, whatever, it's a big analysis. This analysis gives you very high, the diversion of the income, diversion of the expenditure, or the trend of the income, trend of the expenditure, trend of the asset creation, trend of the wealth creation. All trends are examined by the ratio, because you can get monthly also, you can calculate quarterly also, you can calculate yearly also, you can compare the ratio with the other similar industry and similar unit also. So it is a very big benefit available to the accounting person, that by ratio analysis they can conclude lot of things. Okay, and when the divergence ratio is much bigger, there is abnormal deviation, suppose ratio should have been 1:2, in case of 1:5, you can question why it has gone, what is the reason, when it will come back, lot of decision making can take place. Ratio analysis is the best part to take to put the benefit of the decision making at every level. Okay, receipt is receipt, receipt and payment account we have discussed, reconciliation, bank reconciliation, reconciliation of any account, reconciliation of any debtor, reconciliation of creditor, whatever entries we make, what they make, we reconcile. Okay, reconciliation and confirmation is must in the business to the extent possible. Revenue expenditure we discussed, capital and revenue, special fund we already discussed, straight line method I discussed in depreciation, surplus or deficit, trial balance we have already discussed, useful life, this furniture useful life 10 year, 9 year, 10 year, any equipment, any machine, this computer useful life only 3 year with the fast obsolescence. So it depends on the nature of asset. Okay, return on we discussed, return on value method we discussed. Now the accounting concept, this was very important, will take 5 minutes only. Entity concept, first I discuss with you the entity concept. Without that, we will not be able to do anything. So entity is a must, entity is different, I am different. Dual aspect or accounting equivalence comes, dual aspect means one transaction debit, other credit. If there is income, there has to be expenditure matching to the income. If there is expenditure, there has to be matching income to that, whether earned, whether received or not received, but it should be earned. If not earned, it means expenditure has been incurred for the earning to be resulted in future year. So some part of expenditure may be capitalized also, because no earning this year, deferred also. So there should be a dual aspect, one should be earning and there should be expenditure. This would be debit, there should be credit, this would be asset plus, either asset minus or liability plus. So dual aspect concept. Okay, going concern concept I discussed with you, every unit must go. If you are aware that this unit will finish at this place, then all asset liabilities should be valued at disposal value. Suppose all we, I don't want to run the IIT center, then this furniture hall will take, who will take it, has to be dug, it has to be finished, this will be broken, etc, etc, so it will be scrap value. Otherwise it is valuing say 1 crore, or if we destroy it, we finish it, people take it away, then the value hardly more than 50,000 or 1 lakh. So that is the disposal. So going concern means the institution is going on, people will study, industry will go, business will carry on. So going concern, it will go for a long run. Even if you are not aware 2 year or 3 year, it will go a long way. So going concern concept. Money measurement concept, every transaction has to be measured in money. Okay, money measurement concept, without money measurement you cannot discuss any transaction in your life. Money measurement concept. Cost concept, everything has a cost. Suppose somebody told that land is acquired and there is no cost, it has to have a cost to you. If it is not cost, then you have to create a cost, single rupee, to identify the transaction, and then describe free of cost given by the government. You have to disclose that. You cannot say it is cost. There has to be a cost to every transaction. This country is going in a different direction, I am telling you, because I am finance analyst. Production is going down, manufacturing going down, okay, mining going down, everything is being going down. Service sector is on boom. Everybody wants to become IIT. Everybody wants to become chartered accountant. Everybody wants to do everything, okay? Service concept, medical, all medicals are open. All treatments are available, okay? All type of vegetables are available. All types of cloth and China, Vienna, Australia, you need not to go anywhere. Everything on your table, everything available to you. So service sector is developed. What will happen to us? Have you thought sometime? How many years this country will run? Nobody has thought it. I have analyzed it different way. The only money has come to your pocket, to the public, is by valuation of our own land. Every day we are valuing our house, valuing our plot, valuing additional land, valuing agriculture land, selling the agriculture land. Now agriculture is having land value 10 lakh rupees, 100 crore, he sold 50 crore. And then buy it car and then, you know, this and that and IASEI all everything. And that creates you value. He put, yes, this student will go to IIT, this will go there. All IIT are created, okay? Everybody is coming to Bombay, okay? Everybody is going to any state because the land valuation is there. So who has purchased the land? Real estate developer. From where money came? From the bank. Bank says, no, your value is 50 crore. I'll give you 25 crore. How 50 crore? This land can produce 10 lakh rupees grain. How it can be 50 crore? How it can be 50 crore? But I printed money, gave it to the developer. Developer gave it to the agriculturist. Or B, solar. I put my all person IIT or and then car and all luxuries. And the person along with the luxuries, they got money from luxuries, and this way the country is moving. What will happen? God knows. Nothing is going positive. If the production, manufacturing, service sector, export, you go export and bring money to the country, then it is an addition to the GDP. Nothing. Government put all taxes anywhere, put taxes, collect money, distribute salary. Distribute salary, distribute defense. Distribute defense, distribute grain, food grain, narega, mandrega, all such. Make every people finish. For 400 rupees job? No. 400, I am getting narega 300. Why go 400? Work 1 hour only. No work. Any labor? Very costly. What will happen to this country? Have anybody heard? Have you thought of it? What is going to affect? It is a great problem to this country under the severe issues we are serving the country. It is a great problem. Every industrialist, every manufacturing unit, every trader, every commerce people, every public servant, every institution, everybody has to think in a manner how the cost can be reduced, how the cost of living can be reduced, how the surplus can be created, how the waste expenditure can be reduced, how export can be cut down to a large extent, and how GDP is strengthened. Everybody has to think on the issue. Today, if you sell out, we are selling all the plots, tomorrow all banks will close down. All institutions will finish, and everybody will think, oh, what happened to it? Car, war, who will buy the car, tell me? Nobody. Old car, nobody will buy. Old pen, nobody will. All mobile, nobody buy. Is a 30,000 mobile, you ask, 2,000, nobody will give you. So what is going to happen? Nothing. We are in very serious condition. So friends, we have to see a lot of way I have, deviated this thing. But in the country's interest, in the interest of the economy, we have to think and to build a strong power everywhere in the manner that this country is saved. Only because we had a saving system, we are surviving. And we have covered this world meltdown. And now, if again land valuation goes up, all 100 crore, 200 crore, 500 crore, 600 crore, IIT value is 10,000 crore. Sell it somebody who will leave it here. I don't know what will happen to it. But that is the issue. So this I have discussed. periodic matching cost and revenue concept and realization concept. Matlab every asset, every part is realizable. Means, suppose you have an asset, you can sell it and can realize it. If you say not realizable, then that cannot be a asset. And that is the realization concept where we are valuing our own land, all flats, all system, going to a big way, and everybody is, I am also thinking I have two, three plots. Say, yaar, I am crorepati, okay? So this is the system I have discussed with you, and you know, accrual base of accounting, I have discussed with you, cost basis and all concept I have discussed with you, and the learned speaker, my chartered accountant fellow is there, he will be there with you for 2-3 days, okay? We, from this meeting, particularly for my lecture, you only take two things in your life. One thing is, accounting is the easiest thing of the life, but it is a must to adhere the accounting system. We should have professionals always with us. We should carry this accounting as the top important, top priority item, top priority sector in all every business. This will give the eye opening at each every department, each every center, at every place. It should be made on accrual basis all the time. And you people should feel it very easy that it is not a burden on anybody. Once you start, everything will come in the positive manner, in the proper manner, in the things it is desirable, in the manner it is acceptable, and in the manner it is needed by the current society, by the current institution pattern, by the current economy, by the global economy. We have the excellent administrators, the bureaucracy and the administrators throughout the country who are taking care at each and every stage, and we should support them. We should strengthen at every level to the administration so that, you know, everything goes right. If we'll able to give them right figures in the right direction, you know, they are not, you know, expert of finance and everything. They are administrator and the best part playing their own field. So we should give them the full strength by giving full data, complete data analysis and complete control and foolproof accounting so that they can take better decision, and they all taken together, we can strengthen the economy and we can take the India way forward. Thank you very much.
CM Mr. Agarwal is an important person now. He is chairman Professional Development Council in the IKAI. This is one of the most important organ of IKAI. They are basically engaged in manufacturing new CS, conducting exams, developing their professional skill and etc. And he is in charge of that curriculum etc. So he has taken out of his busy and important job quite a big amount of time for us. He has devoted, I think, as a chairman PDC, he is giving lecture. So how much importance IKAI is giving to this type of capacity building program, I think we should appreciate it. And until and unless we start appreciating this, then we will not be doing justice to them also. IKAI is a professional body. Each one of them is owning a big firms, earning in lakhs. But still they are coming here. Still they are coming here, giving lecture, talking to us, because they feel that we should also develop capacity and improve our accounting practices in all the educational institutions. Because educational institutions are the backbone of the nation. All these educational institutions, you represent IIT, ISAR, IIM, they are the backbone of the nation. So that's why they are also devoting so much time. So please try to understand them and learn as much as possible, raise as many questions, but be very practical also when you raise their questions. Questions should be to the point and very, what is called, provoking type questions, so that they can give a very good technical reply, because these are, account is also a technical subject and a highly technical subject.
No.
It's what? Achha, I consider it's a very technical.
It will be taken very easy. Otherwise, you feel technical, you will not be able to understand.
Good way to communicate confidence. Anyway, please give a big hand to CA Mr. Agarwal, and let us break for lunch.